Almost there. Just need this one. There we go.
No. Not like this.
Alize, are you hurt?
A touch dizzy, but otherwise fine. Thank you.
And there you have it. Our friend is too stubborn to die.
We are far from finished. Or have you never considered how we came to this world?
Crystals? You mean, like the Ascians?
Just so. As the Ascians flee unto the rift twixt planes with crystals of darkness, so did these warriors come hither with crystals of light.
Eloquent, as always. Aye, like the Ascians, we too are beyond death. You cannot defeat that which is eternal.
Wait!
Such methods as the Ascians employ require the renunciation of the flesh. You would have had to...
At long last, you see. To save our world, we gave our lives.
We were just adventurers trying to make our way. And our job here, a favor there, we never aspired to be warriors of light. But word of our deeds spread, and soon people were calling us heroes. They placed their hopes and dreams on our shoulders and bid us fight for all that was good and right. We fought, and we fought, and we fought. Until there was no one left to fight. We won! And now our world is being erased from existence. We did everything right. Everything that was asked of us, and still it came to this. You of all people should understand. We cannot, we will not falter. We brought our world to the brink of destruction, and now we must save it.
I've died before, Arbot. I'm not afraid to die again.
No matter how many times we fall, we must rise and carry on the fight for those we left behind.
to have known the depth of sorrow and embraced the highest sacrifice. Nonetheless, Master Louis-Soir, guide my hand, I pray you, as fate's thread spinneth upon this most capricious spindle. Quickly! Thou must needs invoke the power of thy crystal!
What is this place?
Such pain. Such sorrow. Oh, my dear children.
It can't be.
Mother Heidelin, hearken unto your children's plea. From two worlds do we gather, and from two worlds do we offer a bounty of light. In this desperate hour, we do beseech your intercession. We beg an audience with the word of the Mother, with your chosen Minfilia.
Your cries go not unheard, nor your sacrifices unnoticed. Though many are lost, there are those we can yet save, whom I can yet save.
Minfilia!
Blessed children of the First, the light of your world hath grown blinding in its radiance, but it is not yet absolute. I will hie me to your world, and there take unto myself the light which riseth even now to drown it, as darkness once did drown another.
Now you deign to answer our prayers? I will suffer this farce no longer!
As the Asians must serve as instruments of Zodiac's will, so too must others carry out the will of Heidelin. But for the boon you have granted her, she has grown strong enough to set me free, that I might serve as her emissary. Your suffering, your sacrifice, your supplications, she has heard all. We will not let the First fall to light. Thank you, Uriangée, for bringing everyone here. It fills my heart with joy to look upon the faces of my friends once more.
In taking you unto her bosom, I knew that Heidelin had bequeathed to you a sliver of her grace, granting you strength long sought. And in treating with the Asians, I learnt of a star like unto our own, A doomed world of fallen heroes, in whom I glimpsed ourselves. The first. Full long did I search for a means to save this world, concluding at the last that the answer lay in the power of blessed crystals. And thus did I labor to set light against dark. Yet I knew from the beginning that this salvation would not come without sacrifice. For the instrument of the first's deliverance would of necessity be required to journey thither, there to remain, mayhap forever.
You orchestrated all of this, not to save her, but to send her away!
One life for one world. Such was the bargain, and you the coin, though it were not mine to spend.
Have we not walked together in the light of the crystal, and at her bidding borne witness to the joys and sorrows of this land? Each and every one of you knows my heart. If this be the price I must pay, I pay it gladly.
You would go alone, then?
My dearest Thancred, you who have ever watched over me, I am truly grateful for all you have done on my behalf, as would my father be. Your kindness, your compassion, your love. These are your gifts to me, and our gifts to them, forming a bond which transcends time and space.
Sometimes I forget you are not the child I once knew. Make me proud.
Long have I watched you from Hydaelyn's side, watched as you nurtured and kept safe the light of the dawn. The dark recesses of the world hide untold secrets and dangers. Thus do I entrust to you, Tubsimati. I pray you, keep to the path that you may never have need of it.
'Twould seem the power of our crystals is all but spent. Perhaps, if there is naught else to be done.
Hear me, servants of Hydaelyn. If you would have us place our trust in you, then I would ask a favor. Take us with you. Take us home. We were blind to the truth once, so I tell you this. As one fool to another. Light, dark, it doesn't matter. What matters is how you choose to use them. We made our choice and you see what came of it, so please, forge a different path. Seize a better fate.
Thank you. 'Tis a strange feeling. So many times have I watched you depart, my heart filled with worry. And ever did you return to me in triumph. Someday, when I have found a way to free this star from her sorrow, I promise you I shall repay the favor.
Holy crap, that was awesome! The story gets better and better. Jeez, I'm misspelling people's name. Alright, let's do this. This is the end. What does Elise? Elysio? I think that's how you say it. it's over. Where to? Oh, back over there? Teleport. Give me one second, guys. Alright, since I'm back here, let's get my zoo. Sorry, just received a text message about the, he was having problems with one of the worksheets, like which one was due tomorrow, on Wednesday. Alright, where's next? Rising Stones. Where's Rising Stones? Because there's so many stones. Okay, Mordona. Let's go to Mordona. Yay! All of a sudden, this turned into the Muppet Show. Yay! Alright. Whatever. Okay, let's go. And I'm getting hungry. I had like cereal. Boom. Boom. Dun-dun-dun. I want to investigate something. How is my armor? Okay, it's fine. What do you give me? Shit, I don't have any more ESO. I feel so empty. Primal gear, what? Oh, it's these. The awesome looking Geralt's masterpiece. Oh, so it's the like ironworks Rowena's tokens. What are these? Rowena's tokens. Oh, well, these are just glamours now. That looks cute. Two-handed exchange. Uncanny knickknacks? What? Oh, it's all the old items. Oh, I remember getting these. You had to, like, done like your first month or something. Let's check under other. Okay, I'm done. Need to go finish this already. Oh yeah, let me put that on sale. Sale. $80,000, I'll sell it for 70. Oh yeah. Let's adjust the price for these. Screw you, I'm selling it for less. Haha, losers. Repair all. Let's go fast. Cry baby. Nah, I like you.
Back in the solar. It's been too long since we were all together like this. Not since Aftermoon Breeder.
Much has changed since then. We ourselves, most of all.
Though not all who were lost could be gathered here today, we may take comfort in the knowledge that those who are not are carrying on the fight.
While I am grateful to our friends in the north for their hospitality, it isn't half good to be back.
But, as Papalima rightly said, much has changed since we last stood here. The Scions of the Seventh Dawn are not as they once were, nor should we be. Our travels in the north brought us into contact with a host of fine and generous people, and their selfless deeds serve to show me that it is not lofty causes that should inform our actions, but our hearts. And I hope that the Scions might continue in this manner, as individuals driven by individual principles. Provided we all sincerely desire to work towards Eorzea's salvation, I believe the paths we follow to achieve it need not, and should not, be dictated by any single ideal.
Companions bound by a common purpose, free to go whither they will. The idea is not without merit. Very well. I shall resume my research of the primals and the elder gods of Eorzea. Should anyone have need of my findings, you need only ask. I should be glad of your continued assistance.
Well, my main purpose in coming here was to see the signs of the Seventh Dawn restored and my dear friend found. Nevertheless, having involved myself in your struggles, I feel compelled to see them through to the bitter end. For Minfilia's sake. That is, if there are no objections.
You will always be welcome here, Kryl.
Orianger, can we trust you to carry on your investigation of the Ascians as before?
Regardless of mine own desires, I am undeserving of your trust. Having so villainously deceived you all.
Now, I'll hear no more of that. It would be disrespectful of Minfilia's wishes. She entrusted matters here to us, that we might protect this star and understand the truth which hides at her heart. Mayhap I can handle the former, but I think you far better suited to the latter.
No?
Very well. Then out of love for my Lady Minfilia and Moonbreeder both, this shall be my solemn charge.
Papalimo and I should probably return to Thanalan to keep an eye on the resistance. There's still the matter of the Griffin and the Amalja, not to mention the new Imperial Viceroy. That little lot must be worthy of our attention, right?
And what will you do, Alize?
You know I have no great love for organizations and formalities. That being said, this new approach you propose is not wholly objectionable, and we've always got her to keep us from bickering. But I will suffer no titles. I am not here for House Leveilleux, nor to walk in Grandfather's shadow.
Upon that point, we see eye to eye. If it please you, you may think of me as but another comrade in arms.
Well then, Alfie. I, for my part, shall see to the paperwork and the finances with my characteristic aplomb.
I would not have it any other way, Totaru. And we mustn't forget you. What now for the Warrior of Light?
I'm more of a new adventurer, but I like the third option. I would pick the first one.
Indeed.
The path behind us was fraught with hardship. And the path before us will be no less unforgiving. But a new dawn shall break over the realm, and I see before me the faces of those who will deliver it.
Please tell me this is the end. Please tell me this is the end. It's been over 4 hours, which is a miracle, actually.
One world's heroes are another world's villains. One world's loss, another world's gain. Where men go as one, there is life. And where there is life...
My friends, if I may, I would ask that you entrust Tupsiamati to me. Clouds gather upon the horizon, and as Master Louisois' disciple, I would keep it close at hand. Thank you. I shall guard it well.
There is cause to hope. For every ending, every parting, marks a new beginning.
that's it for the main story. Yay! And it's been over 4 hours. This was like the good damn 4 hours that I ever seen. The last battle was awesome. And she's back, which is good. We got some emotional. We got two other people came back. Ida came back. And that other guy right here, he's back, which is good. Alright then, I'm gonna leave it right here and I'll see you guys next time. Bye everyone, and goodbye for now.